Why are authentic relationships important for human beings? Authenticity creates the foundation for meaningful interactions. Authenticity is the ability to be touched, surprised, changed in the relationship with another person, while also staying aware of your own experience, managing to keep in touch with your own feelings and your own point of view. By putting yourself in front of the other person, you recognize them in their autonomy. Authenticity is not a naive or merely spontaneous attitude, but an intentional step towards the other in order to encounter them. In a counseling relationship, authenticity is fundamental to the formation of a working alliance. In the person-centered approach, we consider authenticity to be crucial for growth, healing, and change. How do you express authenticity in a counseling relationship? First, by your continuous personal presence, which means that you really are emotionally involved in the here and now interaction with your client, and that you are not simply pretending that you are interested in who they are. Second, by from time to time intentionally and verbally communicating what's going on for you. This is called self-disclosure. Person-centered therapists use different kinds of self-disclosure. You might achieve self-disclosure by explaining your line of thoughts during the session and giving clarity about your reasons and motives. We call this personal clarity disclosure. For example, saying, "I don't have an answer for your question. I need to think about it for a while." This is different from what we call therapist life disclosure. Then you are saying something about experiences or facts in your life outside the therapy, or about your personal perspectives and values. For example, "When I was a young mother, I also had a full-time job, and in my experience, it was a very stressful combination." Another form of self-disclosure is client content reaction disclosure, which means giving words to your feelings evoked by the client's story. For example, "You lost your best friend. That would make me sad." Expressing how you are affected by the client in the ongoing interaction is another form. For example, I can say something like, "When you speak in half sentences, I have to work really hard to understand you." This is what we call interaction disclosure. Our research revealed many helpful effects of self-disclosure. However, the extent to which it is appropriate to apply self-disclosure also depends on the individual client. This points to the importance of being very sensitive to the specific needs of your client and tuning your communication style to their needs. Your willingness to share your experience with the client assumes that you can admit and accept your own vulnerability, and that you are open to being touched and influenced by the other. Perhaps it is because of this need for admitting vulnerability that no other concept seems to provoke so much uncertainty and ambivalence amongst professionals as self-disclosure. Nevertheless, it is impossible not to reveal aspects of yourself. The question is only how much and exactly what and when you reveal. In this section you will find different articles on authenticity, including many practical guidelines and vignettes from person-centered therapy. Later on, my colleague Monica Gundrum will explain more about the interactional approach. I invite you to be touched and surprised by this challenging attitude.